Hey everyone, today I will be showing you how to recreate this splatter and dispersion effect in GIMP, step by step. Now let's get into it. Now I recommend, if you're a beginner with this effect, to use an image with a solid color background. And once you learn how to use this effect more, you can bridge to more complicated photos. So I have this image of a car. I will link it in the description below so you can follow along. Now to start, we're going to want to select our pen tool, and we want to zoom in and trace around our car. So I'm going to go in and trace around this car until I have the whole thing traced out. Now I've completely traced this car in the pen tool, and I want to go over to my layers dialog over here on the right, and I want to go over here to this paths tab. And I want to right click this path that I've created and select path to selection. Now that we have our path selected around this car, we can go up to edit, copy, and then we can go to edit, paste. Now this is going to create a new layer called floating section. And what we want to do is go down here to create a new layer, or go up to layer and click to new layer. And now, if we hide this background, we can see that we have our car on a transparent background. So what we want to do with this is we want to create a background that was similar to our car, and that would just be a plain white background. So I'm going to create a new layer, and I'm going to drag it underneath this car with the transparent background. And then I'm going to go over to my bucket tool, and I'm going to make sure white is in the foreground, and I am just going to fill in the background with white. Now we want to duplicate this car layer, and we want to right click and go down to duplicate layer. So to create this dispersion effect, we need to use this smudge tool down here. But you can see, if we go to the smudge tool and click a bigger brush and size it up and try to smudge this, it stays in the confinements of this dotted line. So what we need to do to fix that, create a new layer, and then we need to merge that down onto this car. So we need to right click this new layer and click merge down. So now we can smudge this car. So what you're going to want to do, depending on what direction you want the dispersion effect to be, you're going to take and drag this smudge tool and smudge the image in the direction that you want your dispersion effect to go. So I want mine to travel to the top right. So now we're going to add a layer mask to this. And what we want to do is we want to go over to this smudged layer. We want to right click and we want to click add layer mask. Now you're going to want to click the black full transparency mask and click add, and as you can see, it got rid of that smudge. It's still there on the layer, but this layer mask made it so we cannot see it. So now we're going to click on the layer underneath this smudge layer, and we're going to go over to our eraser tool, and we're going to create kind of the dispersion effect on the car first. So we want to click our eraser, and we want to use a brush that kind of looks, it's kind of like a particle or kind of like a smudge, almost paintbrush splatter. I will link in the description which ones I'm using so you can replicate this in your project. And we're going to go through, and we're just going to go around the car and create what looks like pieces that are missing. So now that I've created the design that I like, I want to go back up to this layer where we smudged, and we want to make sure that the layer mask is selected, not the car, but the layer mask. We want to go over to our brush, make sure that white is in the foreground, and we want to use the same particle brushes that we were using to kind of erase parts of the car. And then we want to go in here, and we just want to click, and it will start making and showing the smudge that we were putting in the background. But now it's going to show up like particles So you can go along and just click and experiment where you like the particles to be showing up on this card. And this is what makes each project unique. Your brushes can go anywhere and you can create any dispersion you really want with the different particle brushes that you can use. So you can place them anywhere, click, and you will create this awesome effect. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Make sure to subscribe so you are not left out when any new videos are released. Let me know if you have any questions in the comments or if you have any recommendations for videos that you would like to see. Thank you so much for watching.